Hey everybody, it's Jamie, and it's springtime. Ugh, the weather's heating up and all I wanna do is go outside. Except that I find myself filming so many Do It Girl and See Girl Try videos that I'm always in the studio as opposed to in the sunshine. So I found a way of mixing business and pleasure by making a craft, or three. Because today I'm going to show you how to make three different types of super cute bird feeders. Let's do it, girl. All right, well the tools you're going to need depends on what type of bird feeder you want to make. You may remember from my orange candle video from a while back that I am super obsessed with oranges. So the first bird feeder that we're going to do is an orange bird feeder. For that, you're going to need an orange, some twine, and a pairing tool. The next is a tin can bird feeder, where you're going to need a tin can, acrylic or spray paint, and ribbon. And finally, I'll show you how to make a really cute ornament bird feeder. For that, you're going to need a cookie cutter, two packages unflavored gelatin, vegetable spray, aluminum foil, a saucepan, and twine. And of course, you can't make a bird feeder without bird food. Grab a big old bag so you've got plenty to work with. All right, here we go, orange bird feeders. Step one, cut your orange in half. Step two, gut out all of the pulp so that the inside of your orange is nice and dry. And now we're going to make an orange candle. Just kidding, we're gonna make a bird feeder. Step three, now's the time to grab a pairing tool or anything that's sharp enough to punch holes into the skin of your orange. Treating the orange just like a clock face, punch holes at 3, 6, 9, and 12 o'clock. Step four, take one piece of twine and thread the orange from 3 to 9. Take a second piece of twine and thread the orange from noon to 6. This will form a cross with your twine. Tie all of the strings together at the top into a knot, fill up your orange with bird food, and hang this basket of bird lovin' anywhere you like. A very fun and earth-friendly craft that can be ready in minutes. All right, we're on a roll. Tin can bird feeder, step one. Empty out and clean any old tin can. Make sure to thoroughly wash and dry them with soapy water and a rag. Step two, decorate your can with your acrylic or spray paint. Any color except white, which will scare those birds away. Definitely make sure to wait a few days or until the paint is fully dry before taking it outside. Step three, tie ribbon around the tin can with a tight knot and make another knot at the top for hanging. You can also hot glue or super glue skewers or old wooden spoons to the inside. This will allow a stick-like shape to, well, stick out for the birds to stand on. Make sure to replenish the bird food repeatedly so that way the birds aren't going anywhere near the super glue. Fill up your tin can with bird seed, and voila, bird feeder number two is complete. And for my favorite bird feeder of all, bird feeder ornament, step one. Mix your two packs of gelatin into a third of a cup of cold water. Let the gelatin absorb in the water completely. Step two, heat up about a cup of water in a saucepan and then add your gelatin mixture. Stir this new mixture over super low heat until it's fully dissolved. Step three, add 2 to 3 cups of birdseed and stir until the entire mixture coats the birdseed. It's almost like you're making Rice Krispie treats for birds. You'll know everything is ready and set when the birdseed has absorbed almost all of the water and is now thick with gelatin. Step four, lay down aluminum foil and spray it, as well as your cookie cutters, with your vegetable spray. Then press as much birdseed as you can into your cookie cutter. Take a skewer, break it into a small piece, and place it into the mixture towards the top. This is going to make a hole in the birdseed shape so that you have a way to hang it. Step five, stick your cookie cutter into the freezer for about 30 minutes or so in order to have the mixture cool and harden. Once that's done, you can remove your shape from the cookie cutter. Step six, tie the twine through the hole that you created with your skewer, and boom shakalaka, you've got yourself a bird feed ornament. There you go, three fun, fresh, and easy bird feeder ideas for you. Which bird feeder did you decide to make?
Tweet me at Jamie Petito, Instagram me at Hey Jamie, or just tell me all about it in the comments below.
We did it, girl. I'm Jamie, and you're on Girl.com.
So for our first bead feeder, we're gonna do an orange bead feeder.
What?
Bead feeder, is that what I said?
You did it twice. Twice.
All right, here we go. Orange bead. Except that I find myself, what do I find myself?
You don't find yourself.
I don't find myself. This is a deep show.